Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I come before you to plead for the life of Leon McDuff. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I'm asking you to be the judge of when enough is enough. Now Leon McDuff has worked on his daddy's farm every day since the day that he was born, plowing in the fields and hoeing in the garden and helping pick the cotton and the corn. Then came the time of the Mississippi floods, and all of his work went down the drain. The land was parched by the sun, blown by the wind, and finally washed away by the rain. So he went to his friends to get some help from them, but their crops and their money was all gone. So he went to the bank to mortgage his home, but the bank wouldn't give Leon a loan. He could not decide how his family would survive with no crops and no money to buy food. As he struggled with his hands to rework his land, a notice came that said his land tax was due. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I come before you to plead for the life of Leon McDuff. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I'm asking you to be the judge when enough is enough. Now in an air-conditioned office on the other side of town sat a government official with a frown, 'cause he'd been trying for so long to find land to build a summer home, but cheap river land could not be found. Then in the middle of his gloom, his boss walked in the room, said, "I've got some real good news for the house you plan. There's a farmer who's so poor and whose luck has run so sour that he cannot pay the taxes on his land. So just you wait a week or two until the money is overdue, and then go to the cashier down the hall. With this deed in your hand, pay the taxes on the land. Have the sheriff give Leon McDuff a call. Have him tell Leon to move by the last day of July, because the taxes on his land are overdue. Tell him he has to move away, 'cause the taxes were not paid, and all his river land belongs to you. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I come before you to plead for the life of Leon McDuff. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I'm asking you to be the judge of when enough is enough." Now in that air-conditioned office, in about a week or two, came the sheriff saying, "I've got some bad news. That Leon McDuff says he's had some bad luck, and he'll try to get the money, but he ain't gonna move." That official, he jumped up, grabbed the sheriff by the arm. He said, "We're going down to take that land today." So he and the sheriff drove down to Leon's farm to tell the McDuffs to move away. There stood Leon on his land, with a shotgun in his hand, and his eyes narrowed neath the brim of his hat. He said, "I worked hard on this land as a boy and as a man. I ain't gonna lose it to no goddamn bureaucrat." Well, that bureaucrat got mad, grabbed the gun in Leon's hand, and in the struggle an explosion cracked the air. When the smoke and dust had cleared and the ringing left their ears, the sheriff lay dying on the ground. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I come before you to plead for the life of Leon McDuff. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I'm asking you to be the judge of when enough is enough. this table I will lay this gun exhibit A with two sets of fingerprints you can't see. But other hands were here, unperceived by eye or ear, that helped trigger off this awful tragedy. Now to me it's still unclear just what really caused the problem here. There's much too much we've got to know before we know enough. So we can't find out today where all the guilt should lay, but it shouldn't be on Leon MacDuff. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I come before you to plead for the life of Leon MacDuff. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I'm asking you to be the judge of when enough is enough.